And I would now like to turn to our next panelist. We've got Aris Dimarakis from Kaizen Gaming. Those of you in Romanian parts of Southeast Europe may know them better as Betano. But we look forward to hearing your comments on this subject, Aris.
Hi, Matthew, and thank you for inviting me to participate in this event. Hello, everybody. My name is Aris. I am the CTO of Kaizen Gaming, one of the fastest growing game tech companies in Greece, currently operating in six countries, that is Greece and Cyprus with the Stoiximan brand, and Romania, Germany, Portugal, and Brazil with our international brand Betano. We started as a team of passionate professionals, and after 8 years of hard work, we have established a company of over 750 people with a strong technology function of approximately 200 engineers. We are well known for our investments in technology and innovative organizational methodologies. Lately, we have released our own sportsbook platform, Ariadne, which is a milestone for our future that allows us to design our destiny without constraints. Apart from Ariadne, 3 years ago, we decided to kick off our baby steps into the era of machine learning and artificial intelligence. And it took us about 1 year to release our first tool to our customers. Until now, we've managed to develop 12 more features, but our most important achievement is that we also established a talented team, or tribe as we call it internally, responsible for implementing our corporate AI roadmap. In that sense, the EU's white paper on artificial intelligence came as a surprise. First of all, because instead of a boring legal document, I read an engaging text written from engineers to engineers. And secondly, at least to my interpretation, because they tried to solve a complicated equation, concluding to a paradox, a challenge, and an opportunity. So, what is the paradox? We have three players, Europe, North America, and Asia, competing in a race for AI's technological leadership. North America and Asia are leading the race. We, Europe, invest less money than our competitors. We add our own constraints with data protection regulations. And all that said, we aim to catch up and finish in the first place. Interesting. What a challenge. By reading the document, it's evident that due to the lack of coordination between the member states, we Europe are not even making efficient use of our unlimited budget and resources. So basically, what is happening is that member states do not act as a team, but as individuals. And finally, the opportunity. As said, we Europe are currently spending our time working on the fundamentals. However, since our competitors haven't done so, they are building future challenges instead of solutions, as it happened with Facebook and Cambridge Analytica. In that sense, there is a chance for a counterattack in the future over a healthy growth trajectory. And trust me, my view on things is not theoretical at all. Because we, Kaizen, like any other European company, are facing additional challenges having to deal with data protection regulations and constraints that make our development efforts harder and our delivery lines slower. Still, I have to admit that even if it makes my life difficult, I fully respect Europe's mandate on the topic. EU ensures that AI is at the service of all Europeans, improving their lives while respecting their rights. We live in a period where the need for digital acceleration and tech talent is more critical than ever. At the same time, Betano operates in Romania since 2017. And it's our second most important market. So we are here to stay. And as the next step, In our long-term vision for the country, I am honored to announce our intention to set up a Betano Tech Hub in Bucharest. Thank you.